Assalamu alaikum and peace. Many of our community members come to me with a very specific kind of questions, one that actually resonates with my personal experience. In that kind of questions, they inquire about the extent of human choices when we are often times than not being subjected to many circumstances of life that actually restrict and limit those choices. So they ask me, for instance, you know, well, a child is born to a very wealthy family that was able to send him or her to great schools and to be educated and to have a diverse perspective on life, will definitely think in a better way or in a different way than a child was born to less fortunate parents who did not have the same financial resources to send them to good schools and so forth. And this will definitely affect the ability of this child, whether positively or negatively, to get closer to God and to grow spiritually and so forth. They say, well, a child that was born to parents who were drug dealers, for example, will definitely be different than a child who was born to parents who were great scholars and pious people. If your parents made sure that you get closer to God and learn the scriptures and develop and grow spiritually, you will be a different person when you grow up than a child who was born to the Sopranos, for instance. And these are definitely legitimate concerns, and you know, they even expand the argument sometimes into illnesses, and they say, well, someone is born with an autoimmune disorder, with anxiety disorder, with bipolar syndrome, or there is a hereditary history, a family history of depressive psychosis or whatever it is, and obviously that will affect the ability of this child to lead a normal life and to get closer to God and to be spiritually in a positive spiritual state, as opposed to another child who did not have the same family history, who does not have to endure the same challenges. This even applies to predispositions and tendencies, right? So there is someone that has a tendency or a predisposition to be exposed to pornography, and that now there are actually many biologists that are talking about, you know, exposure to pornography, even child molestation, to be attributed to a particular gene, you know, a homosexual behavior, whatever it may be, even shoplifting. You know, some people are saying that it is also attributed to a gene. So the question becomes, how can God hold us all accountable based on the same standards when we have been subjected to completely different experiences and had, you know, all kinds of different circumstances shaping us and shaping our lives and our futures and consequently shaping our choices as well? So the question becomes, you know, is it nature or is it nurture? Are we programmed to do certain things, or do we still have a choice? And if we have a choice, how much of a control do we have over those choices? And I personally went through a similar experience, you know, when my wife and I were blessed with our first son, Adam, and he was born with this eczema, with this rash all around his body, and it was really was swollen and extremely itchy, so he would scratch a lot, and with that he would actually bleed, and it was so hurtful to just see him going through that as a little child. And my wife would often cry. You know, we never questioned, you know, the judgment of God. We never felt, you know, we never asked, you know, why us, you know, kind of thing. But as humans, we sometimes just felt so saddened. And my wife would ask, you know, sometimes, why is it that only our child has to endure this, and other parents have beautiful children that did not have to go through the same thing? And I've thought long and hard about this over the years. And I found comfort in one particular verse in the Quran that you might find very helpful as well. In that verse, God says, حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do people think that they will be left alone to claim that they are true believers without being tested? We are constantly being put through tests and trials and tribulations in this life. And that is God's purpose for us, in order to push us to the edge, in order to verify the truthfulness of our claims to faith. My test might just be different than yours. So if you are having to endure a challenge in your life, a trial or a tribulation or an illness or a family history or circumstances of upbringing or a predisposition always say to yourself, well, if I have to endure this and my cousin doesn't have to endure it, doesn't mean that my cousin is not going through something else that is only different than yours, right? So if the problem that you suffer from is anxiety or depression, right, and this is your issue, and your cousin doesn't have the same thing, and this is restricting you from getting closer to God, well, rest assured that your cousin or your friend or someone else that might not have the same problem that you have only suffers from another problem. He might have a tendency or a predisposition to be exposed to pornographic material. He might have a predisposition to lie. He might be born to a mother that used to be an alcoholic, so it becomes much easier for him to drink alcohol as opposed to many of us who possibly never have the urge, right? So at the end of the day, every single one of us is being subjected to one particular predisposition, to one particular trial, to one particular tribulation or weakness or illness or tendency, right? His problem is different than mine. I might not be aware of what other people are going through. They might not be aware of what I'm going through. At the end of the day, all of us have issues and all of us have challenges that we have to deal with. What we need to do at the end of the day is show God our best. It's showing Him that we're trying. Is trying to negotiate with this problem and do our best and make the best choices we can ever make. As long as that trial and tribulation does not prevent us from making choices, it only restricts it, right? It only makes it a little bit or a tad bit more difficult for us to make the right choice, right? As long as we still have a choice, God will hold us accountable. Now for me to choose to do the right thing might be a little bit easier for my cousin who has a particular trial or tribulation, but at the end of the day, all of us have choices. And it is precisely how we exert effort to make the right choices under those tough circumstances, it is precisely that defines us as human beings. It is precisely that makes us deserving of God's mercy, that makes us deserving of God's salvation and guidance in this life and the next. I ask God to bring solace to our hearts, to bring guidance and comfort to our minds. I ask Him to give strength to each and every one of us to deal with whatever trial or tribulation he or she is going through. God bless you all, and thank you for listening.